So far, we have learned about three types of things that we can store in a variable: a string, an integer, or a float. In this video, we are going to learn about a fourth type. This type is called Boolean, or bool for short. A Boolean variable can only have two possible values, either true or false. In this example, I have created three variables: a string, name, an int age, and a float weight. Let's create another variable that is going to be a Boolean variable. Boolean variables are useful to represent things that only have two states, either on or off, or true or false. So let's create a variable that will represent if a person is an adult or not. A person can either be an adult or not, so a Boolean variable is ideal to represent it. So I create a descriptive variable name. Is adult is equal to true, or is adult is equal to false. Be careful to write the word true or false with the first letter capitalized and without quotes. If you put it inside quotes, the computer will think that you want to create a string variable, so be extra careful here. Let's change the variable back to true. With this line of code, we tell the computer, create a container in the memory to store the Boolean value true and give the container the label is adult. So now in the memory, we have four variables: a string, an int, a float, and a Boolean. The Boolean variable is the simplest of all because it can only contain either true or false. You may be wondering, how can a variable with only two possible states be useful? Well, let me show you the if statement and it will become clear why Booleans are useful. The if statement is a statement we use when our program needs to decide about doing an action. When we need to make a decision, we use an if statement. To make a decision, we check if some condition is met. We use it like this: if space some condition is true, colon, execute this code. The code will execute only if the condition is true. Let's see it in action with the clearest example possible. If space true, colon, two spaces, print, the condition is met. If we hit run, we can see that the program prints condition is met. Note that the commands we want the program to execute if the condition is met need to be written after two spaces. Every command after the if statement that has two spaces before it, it belongs to that if statement. Let's type another command. Two spaces, print, end of program. As you can see, when we hit run, both commands are executed. If I change the condition in the statement to false and hit enter, as you can see, nothing is executed. The commands after the if statement are not executed because the condition is not met. If we don't put two spaces before the last command, now it does not belong to the if statement, so it will be executed anyway. Let's check it. Look, even though the condition is not met, the last command is executed. So now we know that the if statement checks whether a condition is true, we can use a Boolean variable with if statements because, as we just learned, Boolean variables contain the value of either true or false. So let's change this example to use the Boolean variable we have created before. If space is adult, colon, two spaces, print, f, curly brackets, name is adult. Two spaces, print, he can vote, for example. We hit run. Since the variable is adult is true, the two print commands will be executed as well as the last command. If I change the variable is adult to false, the commands that belong to the if statement won't be executed. Cool, huh? Let's practice what we learned today with an exercise. Create a program that will remind the user to take an umbrella with him if it is raining. Create two variables, one for the username and one for the weather. The program output will be something like this. Hey Nick, it is raining outside, don't forget the umbrella. Please, pause the video now and try to develop this simple program by yourself. Okay, let's create this program. Let's create a variable name to hold the username. Name is equal to Nick. Now, let's create a Boolean variable to represent the state of the weather. More specifically, we are interested if it is raining or not, so we give the variable a descriptive name. Is raining is equal to true. We give it a random value, either true or false. If space is raining, colon, two spaces, print, f, hey, curly brackets, name, it is raining outside, don't forget the umbrella. If we run it, since the variable is raining is true, the program prints the message to the user. If the variable is false, the message is not printed. Great! That was a short introduction to the if statement. We will discuss more about the if statement in the next video. Until then, keep practicing your coding skills and I'll see you in the next video.